My name is Pierre Deceuninck. I worked at the EURL ECVAM, which is the European Laboratory for Alternatives to Animal Testing. That belongs to the Joint Research Center of the European Commission, and we are located in Italy. I work here as a data scientist, which means that I'm collecting statistics and information on the use of animals in experiments inside the European Union. But also gather information on alternative methods, structure the information and make it available to the general public or other scientists that would like to use them. I'm working on creating a report that is presenting with many details the use of animals in experiments in Europe. And this is looking at different dimensions, such like the different type of animal species involved, the categories of experiments they are involved in, or the level of severity of the pain they are experiencing. I think the main impact of my work on the 3 hours is that there will be a possibility to follow the trends and to see how many animals are used in the European Union and if a decrease can be identified. Further looking on the different categories, we can also identify whether the alternative methods that have been developed in the past year are getting results in the terms of replacements of methods used for certain type of chemical analysis. What I really like about my job is the ethical dimension. I think that animal welfare is very important, and I worked in the past on chemical safety, mainly designing applications and database to record the data and information on chemicals. Now, since I joined the EURL ECVAM laboratory, I have this possibility to do the same thing, but also aiming at reducing the number of animals that are in use. And this is something that I really appreciate, because it helps me to, on one hand, continue to contribute to the human health improvements, but on the other hand, also find ways to do it better. I would certainly recommend young people that would like to have a career in this domain to work with the 3Rs and to work on alternative methods. Since the time I joined this laboratory, I really realized that this is a growing area in the scientific world, and that will offer many opportunities in the future for people working in the domain of chemical safety. So for example, I think that in silico methods or computational calculations for estimating the chemical risk assessment will be more and more important in the future, and particularly artificial intelligence. So for people interested in this domain, there is a lot to do.